There is no doubt Auston Matthews is the greatest goal scorer in the game right now, and it's not even close. Unlike most players where they have a patented way to score, such as Ovechkin's iconic one-timer, Matthews, well, he just manages to score in every way imaginable, making him the most unpredictable shooter in the league. On the half wall, where you typically advance the puck into a more dangerous scoring position, well, Matthews, he opts to shoot it. Hovering outside of the slot as a non-scoring threat, Matthews methodically times his entrance undetected by the defenders or the goalie and tips it in. And let's not forget about his toe-drag wrister, quick release, and spectacular hands. Matthews doesn't just beat goalies and defenders with pure skill, he outwits and outthinks them with his greater hockey awareness than most. However, before moving forward, we must also acknowledge the talent surrounding Matthews. If you look at 70 to 80% of Matthews' goals, either Marner or Nylander sets him up. Their own brilliance creates unique opportunities that complements Matthews' ability to think the game through. Matthews' advanced knowledge and Nylander taking another stride in his development has allowed Matthews more opportunities to capitalize on his brilliant release and offensive positioning. However, despite his masterful art of scoring, Matthews, unconsciously or not, has followed in Ovechkin's hockey legacy mistake. July 7th, 2007. Sidney Crosby has just signed a 5-year contract with the Pittsburgh Penguins worth an average annual value of $8.7 million. Crosby had just come off a 120-point season, winning the Art Ross, Hart Memorial, and Ted Lindsay trophies. Now, your time is up. It's your contract season the following year, and you feel you are worth just as, if not, better than Crosby, as you collect 112 points, 65 of those being goals, leading you to winning the Art Ross, Hart Memorial, Rocket Richard, and Ted Lindsay. However, instead of taking a similar pay cut to Crosby, you sign a 13-year deal worth $124 million, making you the highest paid player in the league with an average annual value of over $9.5 million. Fast forwarding to August 23rd, 2023, you have just witnessed the Nathan MacKinnon Show, one of the top 5 players in the league who has just helped his team win a Stanley Cup, and has now signed an extension worth $12.6 million per season. Now, the following season, it's your turn, as you find yourself in discussions with your brand new general manager for an extension. However, unlike Ovechkin or MacKinnon in their contract years, you didn't produce any awards, trophies, or your team has still yet to win a cup, the most coveted prize in the game, for over 56 years. However, you ignore the history, you ignore your hockey legacy, and you sign for $13.25 million to become the highest paid player